In the TV series Minority Report, is this a world where there was a John Anderton and he had his experience from the movie?
Yes, this definitely, everything that happened in the film happened in our world, as evidenced by the fact that the pre-crime program was shut down. It no longer is legal to use the precog psychics to actually predict murders, and I play one of those precog psychics, so I sort of have I don't really have a place to exist. And it's fun. It's sort of, we've been asking ourselves, and people have been asking us, does that mean that maybe Tom Cruise might make an appearance on the show someday? And that'd be great. I would love that if he did. I guess we'll have to wait and see.
Well, here's my thing about pre-crime. They were doing it wrong. You don't ever need to imprison someone because you can always stop them from committing a crime. It was 100% effective, right?
Well, it was 100% effective, but it also was, the problem was that sometimes people were imprisoned for things that they maybe weren't going to do. Maybe that was the whole thing.
That's what I'm saying. The prison is unnecessary. Either you prevent them from committing the crime or they never were going to commit the crime at all.
I see you mean. So instead of jailing them, you just stop them from doing it. That's pretty good. Yeah. Well, you know what? I'm going to tell the writers you said that. That's a great idea.
I tried to explain this to them too.
You did? They didn't get it.
Well, no, they're going to prove me wrong.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
But it would keep you employed as a precog.
Right. I could actually just continue doing what I've obviously built to do. And instead of putting people in halos and taking their lives away, just sort of tell them, no, don't do that. And then, they get to go on living their lives.
But the other interesting thing is that criminals, when they knew there were precogs, they just wouldn't try to commit crimes. They knew they'd get caught.
That's exactly right. So the crime rate went down for different reasons.
I know what's happening.
Yeah, you've thought about this a lot.
I have since 2002.
Awesome.
So what piece of technology from the future would you like to have for real?
A hoverboard. A hoverboard, well, specifically from Back to the Future, obviously, which I understand Lexus is just announced. I saw that video. I don't know if it's real or not. Do you have a scoop on that?
Well, I heard the story you heard.
Right. So I saw the video, and the video, as soon as he steps on the thing, it cuts out to black. So I'm really hoping that's real because I want one of those.
I love that you went with a different future because I love all franchises, so Back to the Future is one of my favorite too.
I'm a sucker for time travel movies and stories and anything that goes into a different era, a different realm. And so it's fun because this isn't a time travel story, but in a way it is, because I get to exist in the world 2065 for as long as this show runs.
So we've come into the future since the movie came out, so how much further along is the future of Minority Report?
It's 10 years since the events of the film, but you bring up an interesting point. The movie was made in 2002 with the technology available in 2002 to make movies, and we've gone leaps and bounds since then. A lot of those were practical effects and very, very rough visual effects, but now we can do stuff in television that we couldn't even do in movies back then. So that's going to be an exciting thing to see what they can accomplish in today's world of 2015 of filmmaking and the TV making.
What about the world of Minority Report, where, we have a new phone every few years, so 10 years in the future of Minority Report, what new gadgets do they have? Do they still do the hand thing with the screens?
They do the hand thing with the screens. It's advanced, a little more advanced. Instead of just swiping, there's twisting and there's zooming. You will see you remember the little spiders that the police would roll into a building and the spiders would start crawling around and scanning idents, looking for, accounting for all the people in the building? Those will exist in ours, but it's a new incarnation of that. So they're no longer spiders. They are, I can't tell you, but there's a sort of another animal that they emulate, and it's exciting. So we don't redo anything from the show, from the film. It's all the next evolution.
I'm happy to hear that. So in a way, is it better to have the series as a sequel to the movie because you can have a new adventure every week rather than you wait years and you have one adventure?
I think so. I think that's the advantage of television, is that instead of being limited by a two-hour story, you can, with a long-running show, you can tell many, many, many hours of stories and continue to evolve that technology and build upon what you did, in the last season.